A very good morning, aspirants. This is me, Yasmin Gill, presenting to you the PIB MCQs of 28th of December. So you can follow all these videos on this particular link and you can also rate and review them. Beginning with a couple of instructions, do watch yesterday's PIB summary, and once you attempt all the questions here in the MCQ section, do mention your scorecard. Beginning with the first question, which among them is a suggestion of Vattal Committee? A. It talks of establishing a separate payment regulatory board, a body independent from RBI for retail payments. B. It has talked about interoperability of payment system between banks and non-banks. C. It has missed the concern of security issues and digital infrastructure. D. It speaks to reduce cash to GDP ratio from current 12% to 2% in 3 years. So this is a very important committee in context of demonetization. And looking at options here, well, the correct answer to this particular question is A and B. Why are C and D wrong? Because firstly, it has talked about security issues. And if you look at D, though it talks to reduce cash to GDP ratio, but not this extreme. It talks it from 12% to 6%, though in 3 years. And as far as the body independent from RBI is concerned, yes, RBI has actually objected to this particular body that, okay, it should not be away from the regulation of RBI, but Vattal Committee has suggested a separate body. So hereby we have A and B as the correct option. Next question. It is not who here, it's which among them is true. A. Specified bank notes is the name given to the legal tender that has been withdrawn. B. In demonetization scheme, old denomination was not permitted in state, district, central and urban cooperative banks. C. Both of them are correct. D. None of them is correct. By the permission of old denomination here, I mean that the deposits were not permitted. I repeat it. The question actually means in demonetization scheme, old denomination was not permitted to be deposited in state, district, central and urban cooperative banks. So accordingly, if you look at the option here, the correct answer to this particular question is only A. And why? See, A is obviously correct. If you look at option B, in demonetization scheme deposit, it was permitted in state and urban cooperative. It was not permitted in district central, but depositing the notes was permitted in state and urban cooperative. So hereby we have only A as correct. Next, which among them is true? A. Japan is the country planning to launch a lunar probe to achieve world's first soft landing on the far side of the moon. B. In 1968, the Apollo 8 mission's astronauts were the first humans to view this region directly when they orbited the moon. C. It is also referred to as the dark side of the moon, as the sunlight never falls on that particular side. So why this is important, we'll come to know in the next slide. Looking at options here, the correct answer to this particular question is, if you look at first option A, this is wrong. Why? Because it is not Japan, rather China, which is planning to launch this lunar probe by 2018. If you look at option B, do not remember the year, just remember it. Yes, Apollo 8 was the mission which actually first time viewed this region, that is the far side of the moon or the dark side of the moon, whichever you may call it, for the first time. So this is correct. If you look at option C, this is wrong. See, this is not referred to as dark side just because sunlight never falls on that particular side. It is referred to as dark side because it is the side which from Earth we people never get to see, though the sunlight may fall on it. So it is not that sunlight doesn't fall, therefore it is referred to as dark side of the moon. And dark side and far side are the same things. So, but dark side, the word itself, is a misnomer. So correct option here is only B. Next, which among them is true? A. Brucellosis is a zoonotic disease. B. It can be transferred to humans via airborne agents as well. C. Human-to-human transmission is also common. D. It's a viral disease. So as I said you yesterday, we will be doing this in the MCQ section. So, this is because the importance lies because of the fact of the conduct of international conference on brucellosis. So looking at options here, the correct answer, the first option is absolutely correct. It's a zoonotic disease which can spread from animals. If you look at option B, transfer to humans via airborne agents as well, true. C is wrong because human-to-human transmission is actually quite rare. If you look at option D, this is again wrong. Why? Because it is a bacterial disease. So hereby we have A and B as the correct option. You can also read about the conference here and who conducted it. Which among them is true? A. ATM transfer automatic teller machine. B. Recalibration of ATMs is needed because of the different sizes of old and new denomination notes. C. Recalibration involves the adjustment of ATM cassettes only. So looking at options here, well, the correct answer to this particular question is only B. Why? C? Because ATM doesn't stand for automatic teller machine, it stands for automated teller machine. And as far as recalibration is concerned, no, it is not just limited to the ATM cassettes. It also involves software updates. Though people who are carefully observing it, you could have got the hint from here, which I forgot to remove, which is both. So the correct question should have been recalibration involves the adjustment of ATM cassettes only. Well, yeah, this is wrong. But if you could have focused on this both word, yes, only would have been obviously wrong. So it involves, obviously, it would involve both the update in software as well as the cassettes. So hereby we have only B as the correct option. Next, which among them is correct? A. India is the world's largest producer of sponge iron. B. It is used as a substitute for scrap. C. It is mainly used in making steel. D. The process of sponge iron making aims to remove the oxygen from iron ore. So this also we did a bit of it yesterday. So the first option is obviously correct. We did it yesterday. As far as the B, C and D are concerned, the correct answer to this particular question is all of them are correct. B is also correct, C is also correct and D is also correct. Next, which among them is true of technical textiles? A. They are manufactured primarily for aesthetic purposes. B. Government of India has announced 15% subsidy for investments in technical textiles under the amended technology upgradation fund scheme. C. Both of them are correct, D. None of them is correct. So technical textiles have a huge potential in India. So looking at options here, the correct answer to this particular question is only B. See, these are not the textiles which are used primarily for clothing purposes or aesthetic purposes, but rather for various other purposes. For example, say medical use, environment protection, etc. So hereby we have only B as the correct option. You can even read more about it. Next, which among them is correct? A. River Thames flows through London. B. Mouth of River Thames is in Atlantic Ocean. C. India has entered into a Ganga Thames partnership with UK. So correct answer to this particular question is A is correct. If you look at option B, mouth is not in Atlantic Ocean but rather in North Sea. If you look at option C, this is absolutely correct. So hereby we have A and C as the correct options. Next question. Water for Health is India's collaboration with which country? Germany, Belgium, Netherlands, United Kingdom. So this is directly picked from PIB and well, the correct answer to this is Water for Health is a collaboration with Netherlands. This was the same whereby even the sewage water from the urban wastewater, which we could even withdraw nutrients from them. So hereby we have only, not only, it's all, C as the correct option, that is Netherlands. Next, which among them is true of Mission Innovation? A. It was launched during Conference of Parties 22. B. India is a partner country to it. C. Department of Science and Tech is the nodal agency for it or nodal ministry for it. So this is also directly from PIB. If you look at option A, the first is wrong. Why? Because Mission Innovation was not launched during 22, rather Conference of Parties 21. If you look at B, this is correct. And C, Department of Science and Tech, this is wrong. Because for Mission Innovation, it is not Science and Tech, rather Department of Biotechnology, which would be the nodal department for it. So hereby we end the MCQs and I hope you like the session. If you do, do not forget to rate and review. Thank you so much and have a great day.